Hey Virgos, I'm sorry, the reading cut off, so unfortunately you're not gonna get to see the shuffling process, but like the cards that I pulled out I thought were so good that I wanted to keep them for you guys and show you what you got. But like I was telling you guys, it's Virgo season, so happy birthday to any Virgos that were born in September, and happy birthday to any August Virgos as well. I don't think I forgot about you either. Happy belated birthday. And just going on to the reading, we're using the Mystic Mondays Tarot. And for your overall energy, you got the Knight of Pentacles. So, like I was telling you guys, you feel a lot of you guys might feel like young and spry and like you ready to take on the world. And like any tasks that you've been putting off, either because you haven't had the time or you just didn't really want to, or this and that, feel so much more doable and accomplishable now. And I think you might be finding that things just kind of work themselves out a lot of the times. Like you might be fully ready to go maybe organize this drawer at work and realize that someone else already has. And you know, normally that's a dangerous game with a Virgo because you guys are so particular about how you do things, but like you look through it and you're happy with it and there's no issues and you're pleasantly surprised about how well things are going. And I think in love, that makes you feel very sort of able to take on the world. I feel like right now you are very much embodying this Nine of Pentacles energy. Because you, if you're single, you're feeling very, sort of like, for me, the Nine of Pentacles is the single and ready to mingle card. You feel happy and content within yourself. Like, a lot of the things that you've been working towards, you've made so much good progress that you're ready to sort of find your own happiness within yourself and share it with someone else. I see the Princess of Cups and I see the Queen of Wands. So, Virgos, you guys might be seeing some options during Virgo season. I see a water sign who might be a little bit less mature than this fire sign, but ultimately that decision is up to you. I feel like this fire sign is a little bit more mature, but this water sign, you know, water signs love very deeply. I think it depends on what you're looking for in a relationship. Obviously, not everyone is looking for, you know, casual dating or a serious committed relationship right off the bat. So, ooh, and you also have the Page of Swords. So, that could be like three possible people that you're looking at. So, definitely, you guys feel very much in your energy. I see a fire sign, I see a water sign, I see an air sign. Interestingly enough, no earth signs, but I don't think that matters to you right now. I feel like you're so in your energy that you can make it work with anyone. And, you know, Virgo is ruled by the sign of Mercury, so you can really make it work when it comes to communication. I feel like, especially now, you guys are like feeling so in the zone, especially when it comes to communication. You know, like, so many people right now are probably appreciating and falling in love with your dry sense of humor sometimes. Not saying that all Virgos have dry senses of humor, but come on, some do. So you might be like just making casual observations, and people are like, wow, that's so astute of you. Wow, that's so funny. Wow, I didn't even look at it that way. And you really are even more so than usual. Have your eye for detail. It's super important to point out here that you have the Hermit within your own reading, and the Hermit is the card of Virgo. So you have the Virgo card in the Virgo reading in Virgo season. So, like, I definitely feel like so many of you guys are in your element. And if you don't feel like you're in your element, I would say, like, try to get into it, because if you do, you're really gonna get into it easily. Like, there's not gonna be a whole lot of obstacles for you right now. I feel like if you were to just mentally prepare yourself to do all these things, you would probably just plow through your goals. Like, Virgo season is all about setting goals. It's all about objectives and initiatives, and you guys have that in spades. You know, I see, and I think for a lot of you guys, you have already set so many goals because you have the Three of Wands, which talks about, to me, that's like the third step. For me, the Ace of Wands is always like, I have this new opportunity, things have changed, and then the Two of Wands is like, now I'm making my decision and making my plan, and then the Three of Wands is like, I've made my plan, I've made my decision, I'm waiting to see the results, or I'm working towards to see the results. And like, I'm not surprised at all that you guys are already one step ahead everyone and already waiting to see your results. So I do think the only thing that I see that could possibly be sort of like a hindrance to you this season is that you have the Four of Pentacles, which also isn't very shocking to see on an earth sign, because sometimes earth signs aren't always the most expressive with their emotions. But I feel like you don't particularly have a whole lot to hide. I think that when it comes to these situations, especially if they do involve more people, like, I would always recommend do what's right, do what's ethical, and, you know, tell people and be honest and make your decisions. And I feel like whatever you do end up deciding on, you're going to see a lot of happiness because you have this Three of Cups, which is, especially if it's someone coming from your past, because the Three of Cups talks about reunions and happiness. And the Six of Cups talks about somebody who's from your past and possibly even soulmate. You know, I should note that the Three of Cups can also have the negative connotation of third-party situations, but I don't feel that at all. I feel like, you know, these people are interested in your time, and if you, you know, cordially turn them down, there won't be any issues, especially since I see the Magician. So, like, if you want to do XYZ, then you do XYZ, you know? Step one, decide what to do. Step two, do it. It's not like, this isn't a month for you guys to overthink things. This is a month for you guys to get stuff done. And definitely, if you guys haven't been taking advantage of what's left of your guys' seasons, or sorry, of your guys' season, 100% I recommend that you start doing whatever you can, whatever you need to do, because you're going to start seeing so many results so quickly. And I just think, like, there's so much positive energy here. Like, overall, I feel like you guys can't do wrong here. Like, as long as you're ethical, as long as you make sure you're doing what's right, you're going to see probably like twofold or threefold return on your investments, on the time and energy that you've invested into your goals. So, like, what else can I say but congratulations? So I wish you guys the absolute best, and I hope to see you guys here for the October reading. I'm so sorry that you didn't get to see the shuffle reading this month, or the shuffling process this month.